Hat, sunglasses, Pepsi,
notes,
sources,
thick skin,
check. You already know. Let's go.
Golden Unblooded is a college football YouTube channel for entertainment. So make sure to hit that like and subscribe button, and let's get into our next college football video.
Don't forget to send gear to represent your team. The address is P.O. Box 360, Liberty, South Carolina 29657.
In this video, I'm going to give another break to the Get It Gang. What is the Get It Gang? The Get It Gang is the group of people that give video ideas, not ultimatums, to Golden Unblooded, and it has helped to keep this show running smoothly in the offseason, because I'll be honest, it does get difficult coming up with content in the offseason because college football fans, even diehard college football fans, they tend to lose interest. So shout out to the Get It Gang. But on this video, I'm going to give you a break. But trust me, I will continue to use your video suggestions. Y'all have great video suggestions. Today, I'm going to talk about a piece of legislation that is of particular interest to Oregon. Yes, Oregon. And I've made a video specifically about this piece of legislation. And it's state legislation that could tie Washington State to Washington at the hip. In other words, if a conference wants Washington, they would also have to take Washington State. I don't think this bill benefits Washington, but I do think that this bill greatly benefits Washington State, because I do think conferences will be interested in Washington. I think the Big 12 is already interested in Washington and Oregon, of course. And I think the ACC could also be interested in Washington and Oregon. What about the Big 10? Well, Washington and Oregon have already applied to the Big 10, and the Big 10 have turned them down. So Washington has garnered some interest from other conferences. It's just, where do they end up going? Because I don't see the Pac-12 lasting. I do think the Pac-12 will give them unequal revenue share.
All right, so this is post-production Golden Unblooded. And while I was editing this video, I found out that the Pac-12 is actually coming close to getting a TV deal, but it is not looking good. The proposed amount that I'm hearing is $25 million per team, even worse than what I thought. I thought they were going to be able to get at least $30 million a team. If it's only $25 million a team, that's not good at all. And you better believe Oregon and Washington will ask for unequal revenue share on that. $25 million for Oregon and Washington State in the Pac-12. That's not enough. This is bad, bad, bad news for the Pac-12.
I think that they deserve it, but it's going to hurt the Pac-12. And those three-fourths of the four-corner schools will go to the Big 12 because they won't like that. They will make more money in the Big 12. They will go to the Big 12, even if they really, really would prefer the Pac-12. Money talks. So this piece of legislation would essentially tie Washington to Washington State. So whatever conference would want Washington, they would have to take Washington State as well, not Oregon. And here's the thing, that's not a bad deal. I was surprised about this, but this is a fact. Washington State has a top 25 fan base nationally as far as fan base size. West Virginia has a top 30. Washington State has a bigger fan base than West Virginia. Yes, that surprised me. But when you really think about it, that kind of does make sense. You ever watch College Game Day on ESPN? They have a tradition, Old Crimson they call it, the flag that represents Washington State. It has been at every ESPN game day. They have Washington State alumni all over the country, and whenever they find out where ESPN is going to go, they contact the Washington State alumni base in that area to make sure there is a representative to fly Old Crimson at ESPN game day. They have not missed an ESPN game day. So I guess when you really think about it, it shouldn't be that surprising. So Washington State has a top 25 national fan base as far as fan base size. They have one of the biggest fan bases remaining in the Pac-12. So personally, I actually think that Washington State is a good draw. In fact, whenever I heard that the Big 12 was interested in the three-fourths of the four-corner schools, talking about Arizona, Arizona State, Colorado, and Utah, at that time, I was like, hey, that's a great deal. I like Arizona, Arizona State, Utah, but not Colorado. I would take Washington State over Colorado. But then Colorado made that big, big, big-time move, went out and hired Deion Sanders for the new head coach. And that raised their value significantly. I would still probably trade maybe an Arizona or an Arizona State for Washington State. Probably Arizona State for Washington State because they do have a bigger fan base. And it gives you a footprint in a new state. You would already have the state of Arizona with Arizona. So why not gain a footprint in the state of Washington with Washington State? Because I do think they are a valuable brand. And they have a massive fan base. And I think it would help the Big 12. So to me, it's not necessarily a bad thing. unless you're a conference that wants Washington and Oregon, not Washington and Washington State. And this is especially bad for Oregon. It really is. What if Oregon is planning to go wherever Washington goes, even if it turns out the Big 12, and I know they're not interested in the Big 12, but let's just say Washington is interested in the Big 12. Oregon would want to go with them. Washington is interested in going to the ACC, and I've made a video on that. That's actually a possibility, depending on what happens with this TV deal. Well, Oregon would want to go with them. Well, with this legislation, that wouldn't happen. It would be Washington and Washington State. And then Oregon's options is Oregon and Oregon State. I'm sorry, no offense to my Oregon State subscribers, and I do have several Oregon State subscribers, and I was very high on Oregon State this past year. I knew that they were going to have a good football team, and that turned out to be exactly true. But as far as brand strength, it's not there. It's not there. I'm sorry. So Oregon having to go with Oregon State, or vice versa, I should say, Oregon State tied to the hip with Oregon because Washington State is tied to the hip with Washington. Nobody's interested in Oregon and Oregon State. Number one, Oregon State is not that strong of a brand. Number two, you're still only gaining one state as far as footprint goes. Conferences would be more interested in gaining Washington and Oregon. That's two different states, two big-time brands, and two separate states. And that's the draw for that. You talk about Oregon and Oregon State. Oregon, yes, that's a great brand, but Oregon State, not so much, and you're only getting one state, so that also hurts Oregon as well. Same thing with the Washington State thing. That's another thing you have to talk about. If they get joined at the hip because of this state legislation, which I honestly think that it's not going to get passed, but it could. You never know. So if it gets passed and they get tied at the hip, then the interest in Washington, I actually do think, goes down. I don't agree with that. But the big draw is getting two states, two big brands, and two different states. So with Washington and Washington State, yes, I think Washington State is a great brand, but you're still just getting one state. However, I will say this. I think the chances of a conference wanting Washington and Washington State are much, much higher than wanting Oregon and Oregon State. I'm sorry, they just don't want Oregon and Oregon State. We'll go to Blue Dude. What about Oregon and Stanford? Stanford is a pretty good brand, and they have great academics. That's true, but Stanford is connected at the hip with Cal. So wherever Stanford goes, Cal will go. Wherever Cal goes, Stanford goes. Unless Stanford decides to go independent, because that has been talked about at length. It is possible that if the Pac-12 falls apart, or they backload with a lot of Mountain West teams, and Stanford and the rest of the remaining Pac-12 teams don't like it, some of them will just have to suck it up. But Stanford could go independent. That's a real-time possibility. And a lot of people think that the Big Ten is trying to get Stanford to draw in Notre Dame. And even if they didn't draw in Notre Dame, they could get Stanford and Cal. And that would make perfect sense for the Big Ten. Of course, I've done a video on this particular subject as well. It would ease the travels of USC and UCLA. Stanford and Cal have great academics, and they have a crap ton of money in research and academics. So yes, they would be an asset to the Big Ten. In fact, I do think that eventually the Big Ten will pull in Stanford and Cal because of those reasons that I mentioned. So Oregon and Stanford, that's not possible. It's not going to happen. So the only team that they could take with them would be Oregon State if that state legislation gets passed that joins Washington State with Washington. So Oregon is most certainly not wanting that legislation to go through because they want to go with Washington. And if that state legislation goes through, it's just not going to happen. So if you're an Oregon fan and you're watching Going to Blue right now, you better be hoping that that state legislation doesn't go through. And I don't think it will. I really don't. I don't think it will, but it is being proposed, so that means there is a chance that it could happen. And if it does happen, that is bad, bad news for Oregon. So y'all know in the comment section, number one, do you think that this state legislation does get passed and Washington State will be attached at the hip with Washington? Number two, do you agree with me that this hurts Oregon tremendously? And number three, if that does happen and the Pac-12 goes down the drain, what conference do you think will end up picking up Washington and Washington State? And what do you think happens to Oregon? That's all I got for this show. Like and subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you on my next show.